You ever just sit around and wonder how to automatically regulate a precise flow of deuterium gas in a high vacuum system for the purpose of thermonuclear fusion? Probably not. But at Project Infinity, this is exactly what I ponder all day. And if you want to follow along, I'll show you how I did it. While working on my fusor project, I wanted to design a better pressure management system. And if you're not familiar with thermonuclear fusion, here's a really quick summary. I'm attempting a method called inertial electrostatic confinement. And to give you the absolute basics, it functions by injecting a low flow of deuterium gas in a high vacuum chamber. There's a high voltage applied between the outer shell of the chamber and the inner grid. And the voltage ionizes the deuterium and accelerates these ions into the grid, squeezing them together so tightly that there's a higher probability of them fusing together, forming helium, tritium, and neutron radiation. The problem I'm trying to solve is to find the most hands-off method to get the deuterium gas into the vacuum chamber for fusion to occur. And because if you let too much gas in, you lose your vacuum, create too much current, and potentially melt and destroy your grid. Not enough, and you get no fusion. So I wanted to find a way to totally automate a system that controls the flow of deuterium to keep a steady, albeit very low pressure of gas in the vacuum chamber without having to worry about it. So this way I can pay really close attention to other factors like voltage control and neutron detection, while letting the deuterium flow rate just get handled on its own in the background. So here's the solution I found, and here's some diagrams to help get the point across. So this diagram shows the deuterium tank, our vacuum chamber, and vacuum pump. The deuterium gas will come from the tank, go into the vacuum chamber, presumably undergoing fusion, and then get eliminated from the system via the vacuum pump. So one way to regulate the flow of deuterium from the tank itself is just to add a simple needle valve. I opted out of this option as it can be really difficult to finally adjust a mechanical valve with adequate precision, and it needs a lot of your attention. So a better solution for me was to use a very low flow mass flow controller, or MFC. MFCs are electronically controlled and can give you more precise flow rates. Mass flow controllers adjust a proportional control valve based on an input voltage. You can control this valve simply with a potentiometer used as an analog voltage divider. I tried this and it works really well for flow control, but I wanted the pressure to be as automated as possible. So I ended up introducing Arduino into the system to fully automate the vacuum pressure. In order to accomplish this, I needed a way to constantly monitor the pressure within the chamber and communicate that pressure to the Arduino. A Pirani gauge is perfect for this, as it has a voltage output which corresponds directly to the measured pressure within the chamber. So this way I can connect the Pirani gauge, Arduino, and mass flow controller in a fully automated continuous feedback loop to maintain a constant pressure within the vacuum chamber. Here are the components I used if you wanted to make the system for your fusor setup. Here's the schematic I made for the system. Over here we have the buck converter power supply with line voltage in. This was really convenient as it supplies power to each individual component, allowing just one voltage input. And we have positive 15 volts going here to the voltage rail, and then a voltage divider supplying 10 volts to Arduino. And then another positive 15 volts going to the Pirani gauge with ground, and a positive 15 volts and negative 15 volts going to the mass flow controller. So the mass flow controller requires both the positive 15 and negative 15. And I also included a switch here. This is a single pull double throw switch on pin 1 to the mass flow controller. So when 15 volts is supplied to pin 1, the mass flow controller valve is fully open. And this is really useful for pumping down the whole vacuum system. With the valve fully open, you have the minimum resistance to airflow possible. And then with the
negative 15 volts applied to pin one, the MFC valve is fully closed. So it works just as a nice fail-safe to make sure deuterium gas is not accidentally introduced into the vacuum system. Here is the MFC's pinout from its datasheet. And then here's the Pirani gauge's pinout from the Edwards datasheet. Over here, I needed to place a 2-to-1 voltage divider between the Pirani gauge and Arduino. The Pirani gauge provides a voltage signal of 0 to 10 volts, but the ADC can accept a maximum voltage of 5.5. So I have the voltage from the Pirani gauge with the voltage divider and compensated for that by doubling the value in the Arduino coding.
I decided to use the ADS1115 ADC. So when you compare Arduino's built-in analog-to-digital converter, it's 10-bit compared to the ADS1115's 16-bit, and it ends up being quite a bit different in terms of voltage resolution. So to break it down, we have the 10-bit is made up of 1,024 values. So if you have an input voltage of 5 volts, you divide that by 1024, you get a resolution of 4.88 millivolts. And that's great, but I wanted to get a little bit more accurate because the equation we use down here is logarithmic. So with lower pressures, it's totally fine for resolution. But when you get to pressures above about 100 millitor, it starts jumping around quite a bit and it's much more noticeable. So with the ADS1115, we have 16-bit, which gives you a much greater value of numbers to divide that by. And unfortunately with this ADC, half of these values are positive, half are negative. So we only get to use 32,768. But when you divide 5 volts by the numbers we can use, we get a resolution of 0.153 millivolts. So we get much better resolution even in higher pressures.
Lastly, I decided to use a smoothing capacitor here. The Arduino's output is pulse width modulated, so I don't know how well a PWM voltage works with the MFC. The MFC uses a piezoelectric stack actuator to adjust its internal valve. I don't know a ton about how these work, so I may have actually had better flow resolution with the PWM signal, but I figured it should work just fine with a constant voltage, so I just added the smoothing capacitor. So overall, the magic happens inside the Arduino. I programmed it to convert the Pirani gauge voltage signal to pressure in millitor. Then it uses that value in a PID algorithm to adjust the voltage output to the mass flow controller, and therefore the flow of deuterium gas. From there, based on the amount of gas introduced into the system, the pressure will reach the desired set point that I choose. You'll see it better in the final demonstration, because I know that's a bit to imagine just by staring at the schematic. You can check out the description for a link to GitHub with my Arduino code. Just keep in mind that this is the first time I've written code for Arduino. I actually learned it for this project specifically, so go easy on me if the coding seems silly anywhere. This is really the most complex circuit I've designed, so hopefully everything makes sense.
Okay, so this is the pad board so far. And just for reference, this is the back. All our connections here. Maybe I'll put like a little side-by-side or something like that in editing. Make that nice. Okay. All right, so here's our main project box. We have line voltage in, supplying the buck converter power supply. And then this left RS232 connector comes in from the Pirani gauge. And then we have output to the mass flow controller with this connector. On top of the power supply, I'm gonna put the circuit board. And then on top of that, I'll put the Arduino. So all kind of layered together there. Hopefully it all fits. Okay, so everything's all wired up. I added these grounds here. They're not actually shown in the schematic, but I ended up connecting them all to the mains ground on the buck converter down there. I got a little sloppy with this because I didn't think to do this before installing the board in the project box, but it's a really important afterthought because I really need a good ground connection for the shielded cables. There'll be quite a lot of RF interference from the plasma, so I didn't want things to get all glitchy with the microcontroller. And it's time to get all this packed up. And here it is. Kind of surprised everything fit in there, actually. But here's the bulkhead for the Pirani gauge. Bulkhead for mass flow controller. And then here's it's full closed right now, floating, and full open for the mass flow controller valve, our line in, and the keypad. So pretty simple operation. Let me plug it in. I did want to show in here, screen B, there's output to mass flow controller voltage. I added that just because I wanted to show the what's going on with the PID algorithm when we actually have this hooked up to the vacuum chamber. And now that we have everything ready, let's go ahead and do that. All right, welcome to the lab. I have everything all set up finally, and here's our MFC controller here. And for the interest of time, I'm not going to explain everything going on here, but I'll explain all the vacuum components and things relating to the controller. So I'll bring you in closer to show that. Right, so we start off over on this side. This is the inlet to the mass flow controller. And the other side of the inlet, that would normally be connected to a deuterium tank and likely a cold trap or something. I'm going to work that out later. But right now we're just connected to nothing. It's just atmospheric air. Our gas flows this way through the mass flow controller around these curves here to an inlet to our reaction vessel. This is the vacuum chamber. And here we would presumably go through fusion. And then we have the port on the back, which goes to a T. And one side of the T goes to the Pirani gauge, measuring our pressures. And then the other side of the T goes to the roughing pump, and the gas is exits the system that way. So I did a little bit of playing around with the PID parameters. And I think I got it decently tuned to this system. And just to make it easier, I did add a little port here to connect Arduino to my computer just to make things a little easier for tuning. So that makes things much more convenient. But I think I got it working pretty decently, so I'll go ahead and demonstrate this for you. All right, so pardon the sound. I do have to keep the vacuum pump running throughout the experiment, and I'll try to fix the sound in editing. There, I hope that's better. So I started off at a low pressure. We're at about 13.5 millitorr right now. And according to Paschen's law, it's relatively difficult to achieve breakdown and blow discharge at this pressure, despite there being a 3000 volt potential difference between the grid and the shell of the fusor. So we don't have any plasma yet, just because that breakdown voltage is just too high for 3000 volts to ionize the gas that's currently in the chamber. So I'm gonna go ahead and increase the pressure to, let's start at, let's say, 30 millitorr, and here we go. So output to the mass flow controller is increasing, and okay, yeah, we do have plasma, and you can see the orange line in our chart over there. We have the observed pressure inside the chamber, and the green line is our set point. So you can see that it had a steep increase in the pressure, and then it's slowly tapering off. That's because as it gets closer to our set point, the PID algorithm kind of slows down the changes in order for it not to overshoot. And it looks like it's undershooting a little bit right now, but the longer we give it, the closer to the line it's going to be, and eventually it'll be like pretty much riding directly on the line. So I'll go ahead and change the pressure to, let's say, 25. And we'll see how things change here. Settings 25. Now you can see output to the mass flow controller is slowly decreasing, and our pressure is changing accordingly. When there's a small pressure change, we're only reducing it 5 millitorr. It's the algorithm is tuned so it changes things quite conservatively, because small changes in our voltage to the mass flow controller valve make quite large changes in our pressure. So it keeps it nice and smooth and more precise. So yeah, we're at 25 now. So if I make a larger change, let's go ahead and set it to 100. You'll see everything acts a little bit more aggressively. So enter, settings 100. And you can see that voltage is changing quite a bit now. And now, yeah, much, much larger change in pressure. You can see the plasma as we change pressure kind of makes fun changes as well. And again, you see that steep increase and then a slow taper to our set point. Oops. So it gets there pretty quickly. Yeah, we're already at 99 point, yeah, we're already at 100. So quite quick changes. So I'm really happy with how this is working. And I'll go ahead and bring us back down to zero. Or I'll set it to zero. It doesn't mean we're gonna get there. So the output to the mass flow controller is now zero. And you can see there's a steep dive in pressure now that's much faster than anything we've seen thus far, just because the valve is totally closed to in the mass flow controller. So the decrease is determined solely by how fast my vacuum pump can evacuate the chamber of gas. So if I had like a turbomolecular pump or a diffusion pump, it would pump down much faster. But right now I'm just working with the mechanical rotary vane pump right now. So now, yeah, we're already down to 13.2 millitor. And it's working beautifully. I'm very happy with it. So I did actually remove that capacitor that was kind of smoothing out the voltage from the pulse width modulated signal coming from the Arduino in order to control the mass flow controller. And I didn't actually notice any difference between my previous tests and these tests. So I'm just gonna keep it desoldered. I don't notice any difference. So just making the circuit a little bit simpler. So yeah, quite happy with how this worked out.
Thank you so much for watching. I had a ton of fun with this project. I got to learn Arduino and some more circuit building skills. There's just a litany of information to know to get this done. So I hope you learned a lot as well. And if you have any questions, feel free to drop them off in the comment section. And if anybody noticed any glaring errors that I may have made, feel free to comment there too, because it's a really good way to learn. So I'm planning on making a lot more videos, so feel free to follow along for those. Some more academic and a little niche like this, but I'll probably make some that appeal to a wider audience and a little more visually appealing and fun. So we'll see you next time. Thank you so much.